ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಬಸವಲಿಂಗಾಯ ನಮಃ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಶರಣ ಬಂಧುಗಳಿಗೆ ಆತ್ಮೀಯವಾದಂತಹ ಸ್ವಾಗತ, ಸುಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಇದು ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆಯ ಸಮಯ. ಶರಣ ಬಂಧುಗಳೇ, ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ತಿಳಿದೇ ಇರುವ ಹಾಗೆ ನಾವು ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆತ್ಮಸ್ಥೈರ್ಯ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ದ್ವಿತೀಯ PUC ಬರೀತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿಗೆ ವಿಶೇಷವಾದಂತಹ ಸಲಹೆ ಸೂಚನೆಗಳನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಈ ಒಂದು ಸಲಹೆ ಸೂಚನೆಗಳು ಖಂಡಿತವಾಗಿಯೂ ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಬಹಳ ಅನುಕೂಲಕರವಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವಾದರೂ ಭಾವಿಸಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಆತ್ಮೀಯ ಶರಣ ಬಂಧುಗಳೇ, ದ್ವಿತೀಯ PUCಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಈ ದಿನ ಬಯಾಲಜಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಜೀವಶಾಸ್ತ್ರದ ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದರ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಪತ್ರಿಕೆ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ತಾವು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ಉತ್ತರವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಚಾರದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಚರ್ಚೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಬಯಾಲಜಿಯನ್ನು ಟೀಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕರು ಈ ದಿನ ನಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನೀತಾ ಭಾರ್ಗವ್ ಅವರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಆತ್ಮೀಯವಾಗಿ ಬರಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನೀತಾ ಭಾರ್ಗವ್ಜಿ, ನಮಸ್ತೆ.
ನಮಸ್ತೆ.
ಹಾಗೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಆತ್ಮೀಯವಾದಂತಹ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಕಿರು ಪರಿಚಯವನ್ನು ನಾನು ನಿಮಗೆ ಈಗ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನೀತಾ ಭಾರ್ಗವ್ ಅವರು ಮೂಲತಃ ರಾಜಸ್ಥಾನದವರು. ಅವರು MSc ಮತ್ತು PhDಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಬಯಾಲಜಿನಲ್ಲಿ. ಅದರಲ್ಲೂ PhD ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ವಿಚಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿ ರಾಜಸ್ಥಾನಿನ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿಯಿಂದ PhD ಪಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅದಾದರೆ ಜೈಪುರದಲ್ಲಿ. ಕಳೆದ 25 ವರ್ಷಗಳಿಂದ ಗುಡ್ವಿಲ್ PU ಕಾಲೇಜಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ HOD ಆಗಿ ಕಾರ್ಯವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಬಾರಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಅನುಭವ ಏನಿದೆ, ಆ ಅನುಭವ ಈ ದಿನ ನಮ್ಮ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಖಂಡಿತವಾಗಿಯೂ ಅನುಕೂಲಕರವಾದಂತಹ ಮಾಹಿತಿಯನ್ನು ತಿಳಿಸ್ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನಾದರೂ ನಂಬಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಬನ್ನಿ, ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಆರಂಭ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನೀತಾ ಭಾರ್ಗವ್ಜಿ, ವೈಸೆ ಆಪ್ ಗುಡ್ವಿಲ್ PU ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಮೇ ಪಿಛಲೆ 25 ಸಾಲ್ ಸೆ ಪಡಾ ರಹಿ ಹೈ. ಸೊ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಪ್ಯಾಟರ್ನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್.
ಸಿ, ಫಾರ್ ಬಯಾಲಜಿ there are 2 sections and totally children have to answer 37 questions of 105 marks. Out of that there is a choice also, they can attempt the extra 35 later if there is time. And biology actually is a very easy subject compared to others. I mean, you need to work hard, but there is no formula, there is no numericals to be formed, it's all theoretical, so it becomes little easier for children to shoot up their percentage.
Okay, so now I just want to know, I mean rather we all the students wanted to know, can you just go part A, part B like that, so that you can just tell us how many marks are kept for part A and part B?
See, basically part A contains 10 questions.
Okay.
And there is no choice.
Okay.
Please remember, it is a compulsory section, but they are very easy, one word or one line to be written.
Okay.
Nothing more than that.
Okay.
And they score full 10 out of 10. We go to next part, part B has around 8 questions and they need to answer 5 questions, each of 2 marks each. So it becomes another 10.
Okay.
So if they answer this easily objective types, they get already 20 marks in their pocket. And another 1 mark actually is needed if they just want to, you know, at least pass. But I am not suggesting children should pass. Remember, you all need to aim for 70 out of 70 here.
Okay. You said for the second part B you told.
Yeah, part B.
Can you just take one example and then
say
read
part
out the
B,
question and then how we have to answer.
If we see old papers or anything like that, see for section 1, simple question will be there. What is the function of Sertoli cells? You can just write nutrition to the sperms, over. Section B, just asking 4 symptoms of Down syndrome. Now here what happens, you need to write, because it's written 4. You should write 4 symptoms, half mark each it is. It is divided on value points.
Okay.
So if you get 4, please write 4. But since we know each question is 2 marks and nothing is mentioned, you can write 4 so that even if the examiner gets a chance, he or she will not be able to cut your marks anywhere.
Okay.
So to be safe, that's how we answer.
Okay. Then how many questions will be there in part B, Neetaji?
18. There are total 18 questions.
Part B.
Part B. Part B is only 8.
Okay. So do we have
totally
choice?
Part A and Part B has 18.
Okay.
10 in Part A is compulsory.
No, no, Part A we have finished talking.
Yeah. Part B is 8 questions.
8 questions. Do we have choice?
Out of that, 5 only to be answered.
Okay.
That is why 5 of 2 marks each, we need to answer for 10 marks.
Okay. Then what about, can we go to the next
Now next
section?
Is Part C. It also has 8 questions. Out of that, you have to attempt only 5. Now each one is 3 marks. So here how we actually suggest is, either they have asked directly, write 3 symptoms, write 3 points. You write 3. You get full 3 out of 3. In case they have not mentioned, again follow the same system. Since it is 3 marks, write 6 value points so that you are able to get full 3 marks. So this makes it a section C of 15 marks.
Okay.
So first section was 1 mark each, section B is 2 marks each, and section C is 3 marks each.
So can we just have one question?
Yeah, for example, say very clearly, it can be a diagram. Draw a diagram. So if it is diagrammatic question, remember, if it is 3 marks, we need to label 6 parts.
Okay.
That's how it moves. For every 2 marks, 4 labelings. For every 3 marks question, 6 labelings. When we move further, we will see 5 marks, you have to write 10 labelings. That's how it moves.
Okay, then we have, can we go to the next main?
Next part is Part D, which is divided into 2 sections. Now earlier it used to be D, E, F. We don't have that system now. Now it's only Part D, where we have section 1 and section 2. But both are of 5 marks each. These are lengthy questions, which you have to write in around 200 to 250 words.
Okay.
So you need to, you know, be more specific and give them around 10 value points so that 5 marks full can be given to you. And another thing is, in Part D, you have to attempt 4 questions. There is a choice. They have 6, out of that they have to attempt 4. Another is section 2 of Part D, again if you see, you have to answer only 3. Again, but of 5 marks. Now here, if you get a diagram, you should label 10 parts and you get full marks there. Nobody can cut your marks there. In case it is not, best is to attempt question. For example, I'll say, they'll ask you, give the meaning of the following terms. It's just one mark each and they have given you 5 terms. Just write 5 definitions, one line each. Easy to attempt, easy to get marks also.
Okay.
So this is section 2.
Okay.
And they have lots of questions where they'll ask you, what is the reason? If it is not mentioned, always try and analyze. If it is 3 marks, write at least 3 reasons. If it is 5 marks, give 10 reasons, because these are lengthy answers. This all will help us to get a centum actually. You can score 70 out of 70 also in biology. And remember, the 3 main instructions given on the paper also. Unlabeled diagrams do not fetch marks.
Okay.
Any question where a diagram is required, you have to draw, whether instructions or the questions have said it or not. Biology means diagrams. So don't leave the diagrams unlabeled. If anywhere it is required, you should always illustrate your answer with the help of a diagram.
Okay. Will the students will be very happy to listen to the, do they have a nature of loving and anything, something?
See, first thing I would suggest, we should do what we love. That passion of that subject should be there. So if you love biology, you have been loving it maybe from lower classes, you should go for that subject. And I feel biology is life, all about life. If you love life, please love biology.
Okay. So can, how to get 35 and get passed? Then later you explain us at least some 50, 60 first class marks. And then later on you can just even focus on the students who are very ambitious,
very good,
who want to take 70 out of 70. Can you just explain us?
See, one good thing is about PU board. They have split it into theory and practical. And now practicals are of 30 marks. All the children find very easy to do the practical. We make it easy as teachers for them. And minimum requirement out of 30 is only 14 marks. And it's easy to do because they get marks for Viva, for records. All of them do very well. out of that, if we remove from 35, 14 marks, they just need to get 21 more. As I explained to you all, if you attempt section A and section B of 20 marks, you just need one mark more, which is not tough at all, I feel. It's not impossible. So each child easily can score 35. So our aim should not be 35 children. We should aim for higher skies.
Yeah.
When we aim for higher sky, at least out of 70, 65, it's not impossible at all. It is really possible. You just have to work hard. And how to do that? Solve old papers. Look for repetitive questions. PU board has come out with a nice handbook. Please try your hand at that handbook. It really helps. Go to your teachers. Take help from them. All teachers are there to help you out. They will explain you what is more important. There are many more tips which we can give to the children. Like, for example, I'll tell you, go and learn all the words and definitions and terms given in bold letters or italics or any definition, any laws. Those are most expected questions in section A and section B. So you can score full marks there. Go through all the diagrams and abbreviations. Let me remind you, all of you, please read all the abbreviations. They should read that, because abbreviations carry full one mark. Another example I'll give is very important thing, which is Mendel's laws. If you get a question there of Mendel's laws, please mug up the ratios. In any question, one mark is given to the ratios. So these important tips, like how to go about it, will help all of you to do well. So my suggestion is that, you know, take a call on which, when you get a reading time, please go through the questions, decide which one I know the best. Don't think about the question which you don't know. They should know about the question which they know. Attempt that and then think about it. What I don't know. So what you know, write it properly, nicely, under points. Whenever you write any questions, any important biological word, please underline that. That is very important to underline, so it catches the eye of the examiner and he or she will understand, oh, the child knows this.
Okay. Now we can, I want you to explain one particular question which required to do the diagram.
See, for example, for 2 marks, you might get a question like, draw a diagram of a bioreactor or a scrubber. And mostly they will try and give you questions, we don't have to work hard, it's just 2 marks. So you should label it 4 points. Hey, you will show polluted air entering, clean air coming out, and how it is getting filtered by use of lime water and maybe a blower. So we need to label those parts, so that 4 labelings and you get full 2 marks.
Okay.
Now 5 marks, if you want to know, say they will normally give diagrams where you really have to, you know, make little effort, and say embryo sac, they will give a label diagram of embryo sac. There are so many things there. You can label the integuments, outer and inner. You can label a funicle, a clasa, and then maybe an embryo sac inside. So total of 10 labelings will be there. Keep your diagram proportionately good in size. Make it neat. It should not be done, you know, here and there marking. Always use pencils for your diagram. Don't in a hurry, you know, use pen and make a mess there.
Okay. Other than this syllabus part and the question paper, other than that, so you being a lecturer, I want you to explain something else, how to grow the confidence in a student. Sometimes some students are very good, some of them below average and all. Somehow the student has to get passed in the exam.
True,
so
true, yes.
How to grow the confidence in them?
See, as a teacher, and all teachers are mothers also. So I would suggest that, you know, as a mother and teacher, what we can suggest to children is, one is, be confident about whatever you have studied. Don't get nervous about, oh, I didn't do this, I didn't do that. That can happen even with us now. So there's nothing to worry. Be confident about what you have studied. Now, while you are preparing, always try and do time management. You should always know, oh, from today, if you count, I have around 10 days to go.
Yeah.
Those 10 days, divide your time among all the subjects so that you know which subject to study when, say, this days I am giving to maths. Or maybe during one day you want to study physics, chemistry, biology. Divide your time, and main thing is to follow it up. Mm-hmm. Should not happen, you know the timetable, a lesson plan, yes. But you don't follow.
yes.
So we all need to stick to time management.
Yes.
Secondly, what we should do? We should eat well. To follow this timetable, you need to have energy.
Okay.
So we all should eat well.
Exactly.
Have lots of milk, nuts. Don't eat fatty foods which might
Green
put you to sleep. Yes, fruits and vegetables and more of it. And
what about sleep, Neetaji?
Yes, 8 hours of sleep. Definitely, and before the exam, definitely you should not deprive yourself of sleep because a peaceful mind is definitely required the next day when you go to the exam hall.
Okay.
Also, never study continuously for hours together. Give yourself a break. Say 3 hours I have studied. My break doesn't mean that you should use mobile or go on social media. No. My break, what I am telling you all is maybe talk to your sister, talk to your mother, walk around, take fresh air. That itself will allow you to have that breathing time.
Okay. So, this is one thing. Sometimes it so happens some of the students are not that bright due to some family problem, any other problems. They may not be able to cope up or they won't study and all. Sometimes they fail. So, they go into deep depressions, and then we have seen after the second PUC results are out, sometimes some children will commit suicide, they go into depression, so many other things are there. How can we stop all this, Neetaji?
See, I will always say one word. Failures are stepping stones to success. Many of great people, many of so many scientists we name, have failed in somewhere in their life. So, don't get depressed about it, and PU board is so good, it is giving you another chance of a supplementary exam. Take it like a learning lesson. The mistake may be whatever you have made, you have not studied well, or maybe unfortunately there has been a problem in the family. You have supplementary exam coming up after some time. Study well and you can do well in supplementary. Rather, if I can suggest, some children are allowed to actually improve their marks. Due to any reason you feel, I could have scored better. PU board allows you to forfeit your main exam and you can go in for supplementary. So, I feel there is nothing to get depressed about it. They can easily try and go in for a supplementary session, and I am sure they will all clear the exam.
Dr. Neeta, see, in last year question paper pattern was different. In 2018, it was a section B, and now you told me for this preparatory, the students have written the new pattern.
The new pattern,
but
yeah.
But whereas the syllabus is more or less same only the pattern
is
changed.
Syllabus is changed.
See, how far it is useful for a student to go through the last few years question paper? Is it really helpful?
Yes, it will help, because see, there are certain things which are retained in the new syllabus also. And there are certain biological terms, certain diagrams, which have been very, very important, not only for PU, I will say for biology. So, if they refer those papers, they will definitely get an idea what are important questions and what is the tendency to be asked in the board exam.
See, soon after the second year PUC, some students go for medical.
Yes.
And some students may go for engineering, or some can go to the BSc also. Whereas some of the students don't even study biology after this, once you go for a BE or any other.
Yes, yes, could be.
See, how far the biology will help throughout their life. Biology is not only for getting the percentage, only to pass. We don't have to study biology. Biology is such a beautiful subject that the knowledge of biology will going to help you throughout your life. What do you say, Neeta?
See, because I feel, as I told earlier also, the meaning of biology itself is study of life. We all are living our lives. So, to know in general what my body is, how my body is going to react with the environment, how my body is going to react with another body. Maybe you are not going to study, like you told, they might not take medicine. But still they need to know little. And let me tell you, in engineering also there are many fields which are connected to biology. They can do biotechnology, food engineering, where biology will be part of either physics or chemistry or maths also. So all the science subjects actually are correlated. So we cannot say, you know, that if they have taken biology, it might not be helpful to them. And if you see globally the trend, it is important for a child, if they go to US or UK, to know biology, which helps them there for further studies.
Okay.
This is what I have studied.
Okay. So, we have a syllabus in front of you.
Yeah.
Which part, which lesson that you like so much that even students also were very happy to eager to know? Do you have any such examples that so that you can explain to us a particular lesson, particular part? And
see, children mostly prefer to understand and learn subjects which are very close to them. Say, for example, when I'm teaching them about the flower,
okay,
they see flower day to day throughout their life.
They
all are very happy to understand the different parts of the flower and all that. Then there is a unit of ecology, environmental sciences. That also they all feel it's very close to them. So they all love to know and easy to understand when we explain something about trees and something about animals. So these are some chapters which they all, you know, love to go through, and it's easy for them to digest, I think.
Okay. So for the PhD, you have chosen tissue culture. Just tell us what is that.
And actually, it is part of second PU syllabus also.
Okay, that's good.
And I remember when I teach my children, they all love it because few of them know that I worked on it.
Okay.
Tissue culture is nothing. It's a part of biology where we take a tissue and culture it in the lab under artificial conditions. So when the tissue grows, we are able to say if it is animal tissue, we can make different parts out of it. It is going on now. And in what I did was, I was able to make a completely new plant out of the leaf tissue actually.
Okay.
So this actually, children find this tissue culture also very interesting, and it's part of the second PU syllabus also.
Okay, that's good. Do you have any tips to give to our children? One is syllabus oriented, syllabus related.
Yes.
Other than that, any other things that you want to share with us?
I first of all will wish all the children the very best for the exam. And we just can't depend on luck. So don't depend on this best of luck. We all have to work hard. Go through the syllabus. See, there is a blueprint given behind your textbooks. If you refer that blueprint, you will be able to judge which chapter has how much importance in the PU board question paper. Based on that, you can decide which chapters I should give more importance and go through them. Turn the pages and see the block letters. You will find there are different words given, different definitions given. Do that. And plan it out. If you feel I'm not able to do the full syllabus, you can always take a call on which chapter maybe, you know, I'm not very comfortable with. You can easily skip that chapter also, because there is a huge choice. You saw except section A, there is a big choice given by the board. It is a student friendly question paper, I will say.
Okay.
So if you are friendly with the syllabus, you do it properly, the marks also will be very friendly to you.
Nowadays, you know, the youngsters, that to the second PUC students, they're always into mobile, Facebook, internet and all. So I don't say it is a bad habit, but whereas during examination, how far it is useful and what are the disadvantages that we always see in the classroom or in the college?
See, my suggestion would be, Dr. Girija, that they should, at least for that, keep themselves away from these distractions. See, it's not that you're just talking, you will be tempted to maybe go on to WhatsApp, Facebook. It is not going to help us at all. So best is to keep away and not to distract yourself with these things.
Okay.
So keeping away from mobile, social media or even TV for that matter is a good choice. You can entertain yourself, as I told you, take a walk, fresh air, talking to your friends, peers.
Okay. ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಶರಣ ಬಂಧುಗಳೇ, ಇದುವರೆಗೂ ಗುಡ್ವಿಲ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಕಾಲೇಜಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಯಾಲಜಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಜೀವಶಾಸ್ತ್ರದ ಹೆಚ್ ಓ ಡಿಯಾಗಿ ಕಾರ್ಯವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನೀತಾ ಭಾರ್ಗವ್ ಅವರು ಬಂದು ಮುಂಬರುವಂತಹ ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀವಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ, ಈ ಬಯಾಲಜಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಉತ್ತರವನ್ನು ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಅಮೂಲ್ಯವಾದಂತಹ ಸಲಹೆ ಸೂಚನೆಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಬಸವ ವಾಹಿನಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಬಸವ ವಾಹಿನಿಯ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾದಂತಹ ಅಭಿನಂದನೆಗಳು, ಹಾಗೆ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಗಿರಿಜಾ ಫಾರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಮೀ ಹಿಯರ್. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇಜರ್.
ಓಕೆ. ಇದು ಬಹುಶಃ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಬಹಳ ಉಪಯೋಗ ಅಂತ ನಾನಾದರೂ ಭಾವಿಸಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಶ್ರೀ ಬಸವ ಟಿವಿ ಇದು ಸಂಸ್ಕಾರದ ಬೆಳಕು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಶರಣು ಶರಣಾರ್ಥಿ
ಬಸವ ಗುರು.